Hey folks, so here's a quick infographic on business parks in case this comes up in your revision. I have got another one on science parks that you may have already seen. Business parks are similar, but they have the similarities and the differences. Now I've cheated and I've put a map of the UK in because my drawing skills are not up to that. So we're looking at business parks in the UK. Now, interesting, it is in changing UK economy, but there aren't actually a great deal of business parks in Scotland. So when I googled it, I found that most of them are where I'm drawing my dots on here, sort of central, northern, parts of southern England. The one that we're going to focus on is where my arrow is that I've just put on, which is Cambridge Business Park, which was opened in 1970. So we're just going to draw an arrow to that and write our case study, because AQA absolutely love you to have a case study and it helps you access those higher grades. And it is Cambridge Business Park. So we just pop that in there. And we did say, didn't we, it was opened in 1970. Now there are more and more business parks being opened, so I'm sure that number is just going to go up and up, and I'm sure they're going to spread out further as well. Let's have a look, before we come back to that one, let's have a look at what's going on with these business parks. So, first thing to know is business parks are located on the outskirts of towns and cities. And there's a very good reason for that. They're located there because of easy access, via road or rail, but also they don't need to be in the city centre. So they're happy on the outskirts of town. There's more space, so they can have bigger premises. They don't have to worry so much about high costs, it's often cheaper. And that's generally where we tend to see them. So you might see them maybe if you're ever in the car and you're driving on the motorway, you might spot some, think, oh, that looks like a big warehouse or a collection of warehouses. And that's why. So they need to be out on their own with lots of space, but also with easy access. Now, all business parks have what we call shared amenities. So these might be car parking, catering facilities, gyms, shops, but they're almost like mini towns themselves. So they need to have those shared amenities, it's called. Because you're not in the city centre, you can't just pop out for a sandwich. You actually need to have these things where you are. So shared amenities, such as obviously car parking, and all the businesses will share the same big car park or car parks. Catering. So within it, there might be, you know, Costa coffees and things like that, as well as food trucks. But yeah, catering facilities, gyms, and shops as well. Not a huge amount of shops. We're not talking, you know, like a big shopping mall, but there'll be some things there for them to buy. And what the other thing that they have in common is they are all basically warehouses, distributions, and offices. So tertiary, they are all made up tertiary industries of, so warehouses, so think massive warehouses storing huge amounts of goods that are ready to be distributed. And by distributed I mean, you know, big lorries. Think kind of like Amazon, you know, you've got lots of products that need to get out to the right people. Distribution services, so it all has to go somewhere before it goes to like the supermarkets and so on. But also offices, and they are all what we call tertiary industry. Okay, post-industrial economy, a lot of what we do now is tertiary industries, but science parks in my previous video is all called ternary industries. But business parks are tertiary. So let's think, we've got one more to do. I've put on easy access. They also have 24-hour security. Now this is normal in a business park, so 24-hour security, it would be a very secure site, and that's because the value of the goods that are there. You know, you've got to make sure that it's really, really well looked after. And yeah, it's got lots and lots of security there for everyone. And that's because there are lots of companies, 1,400 companies giving 41,000 jobs to different people. Okay, and that's direct jobs, that's not indirect. So the lorry driver isn't always a direct job, that might be from a different company, but is using the business park. So let's put direct. Okay, so it's quite a big employer. Right, let's come back to our case study of Cambridge. Cambridge is obviously a beautiful place, really, you know, a place that a lot of people want to go and live in. And actually, the business park is quite nice. There's lots of green space. So pop a couple of trees in and just write green spaces. It's not an ugly place. It's not all concrete. So green spaces, really good for people. It's going to improve their kind of mental health when they're working there. They can go for a little walk. They can have improved air quality. The Cambridge Business Park is located right next to, let's put an arrow over here, Cambridge Science Park, which is no sort of surprise. And that's because they will share knowledge, information, and employees probably as well. Some examples, the BBC are there, okay, doing what they do best, making programs. Ernst & Young, which is an accountant. I don't need to explain that. Well, I'll put TV. There you go. Ernst & Young is accounting. Okay, very important business. And then we've got another one for you, which is Redgate. Now, Redgate makes software. Okay, one of them. Almost, or that cool ternary industry, actually. So yeah, there you go. There's your case study for business parks. You've got some nice examples in there, and you've got all the things that business parks have in common. Well done.